knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
In the previous tutorial, we examined lithic artifacts. Another type of artifact widely used in the past that preserves very well is ceramic material. Often called pottery in vernacular terms, archaeologists refer to any hardened clay artifact as a ceramic. The addition of other materials to the clay makes ceramics vary quite a lot. They range from China plates to Greek vases to Neolithic bowls. It's very rare for an entire ceramic piece to be found whole in the ground. It is much more likely to find small fragments of a larger piece. A ceramic fragment is called a sherd. Ceramics can also be put into typologies to better date and identify them. To do this, we need to be able to describe a ceramic. Paste refers to the clay and additives used to make the ceramic. Other materials must be added to raw clay to help it hold together, otherwise it wouldn't survive the firing process. Materials added to a paste are called temper. Common tempers include shell, sand, bone, and many others. Identifying a ceramic temper can be difficult and sometimes requires a microscope to inspect the ceramic. Often, a culture will have a signature paste with consistent levels of temper across all their ceramics that can be used to identify them. Another attribute of ceramics is treatment. This refers to how it was fired and any glazes used to finish the ceramic. Usually, a higher heat treatment will result in a smoother and glossier outside. Different pastes also change color based on the temperature that was used in firing the piece. Finally, a piece can be described by its decoration. This includes coloring, patterning, writing, and artwork. Different cultures around the world have very distinct art styles, which manifests in their ceramics. With these three attributes, pottery can be distinguished from one another to be put into typologies, which we can attribute to certain cultures and time periods. As new technologies were discovered around the globe, some cultures began moving away from lithic and ceramic use, replacing both with metal. All cultures still used lithics and ceramics, but metal became more and more important to these groups. While historians have long used ages, such as Copper Age, Bronze Age, and Iron Age, to describe the appearance of metalworking and their dates, this is only applicable to Europe and surrounding areas. For example, while Europe was transitioning from the Copper Age to the Bronze Age, Africa was beginning its Iron Age. Many other societies practiced metallurgy but didn't rely on it for tools. For example, the Aztec Empire made many bronze ceremonial artifacts but preferred using obsidian and ceramics for everyday use. Metal artifacts are also grouped into typologies, from bronze swords to silver coins. One of the most important characteristics of metal artifacts is identifying the type of metal used in its creation. Metallography can reveal the exact proportions of different elements used in an alloy. Like ceramics, many cultures had signature blends we can look for to attribute the artifact. Shape, color, and decoration are other describable characteristics of metal artifacts. Lithics, ceramics, and metals are the most common artifact types in the archaeological record. However, many others exist and are important in archaeological interpretations. Bones, both animal and human, are critical to archaeology. We will discuss human burials in greater detail a bit later. With animal bones and charred plant remains, we can get a view of what people were eating at a site. Another important artifact is fabric and textiles. However, preservation of these artifacts is very rare and are usually only found in deserts and other places with low humidity. Next, let's look at a material remain type that helps us contextualize artifacts we find: features.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.